Okay, we're back at the nursery. I'm Gary Johnson with the University of Minnesota Department of Forest Resources, and we're going to talk a little bit about staking now. Staking sometimes is done at planting time. More frequently it's done after planting, and you notice there are some problematic trees that are listing to the left or right or whatever. But in case you want to do it at planting, there's nothing wrong with it, so long as you follow some basic rules. There are 20 trees planted in here, all the same size species. There are about two of them that need a little bit of straightening. And I'm going to stake these eventually because I've had to straighten them about three times now. So that tells me they need to be staked for the growing season. So again, hopefully we want to have it staked up about this straight. For whatever reason, our prevailing winds come from that direction, but this tree always stakes this way. So our point of attachment for this tree will be on this side to pull it into place. So something along those lines. And we're going to demonstrate three-point staking and the stakes and everything on another tree. But at this point, all I want to talk about is where to place the attachment. Ideally, it's about two-thirds the distance from the ground up to that first branch. Unideally, would be up in here. Don't do it up in here. Up in here holds it too rigid. This is not necessary for smaller trees, and it really doesn't help them develop the caliper development that they need to have. And the only way they get that is by good movement of the stem. So we're going to attach it down in here. The second thing, so that's kind of point of attachment, is how do you attach it? Do not use old garden hose with wire going through it. Do not use it. It's going to cause problems because you're going to forget about it. Use something wide and flexible like this. It's just canvas strapping, or you can use synthetic strapping. It's got two grommets in the end. Just put it around there. Use either a wire or a rope attachment here. Attach that to the stake. Now it allows the tree to move. Because the whole thing about staking is we don't want to keep a tree rigid. We just want to keep it from flopping out of the ground or growing crooked. So that's kind of the principle with this. If we were in a site that, and I'm confident just on this tree, just because I've watched it for a month now, that one stake is going to take care of it. If it ends up that one stake doesn't take care of a tree, you would normally have one attachment and stake to the windward side, one attachment and stake to the leeward side. So you'd have two attachments around the stem, and that'll still allow it to move back and forth. The next tree we look at, we're going to have three attachments on it, and for a specific purpose. So let's go up and take a look at that tree. We just left the smaller tree that we figured it would take one stake to pull it out of its lowly lean. Now we're looking at a newly planted tree, and this was a bare-rooted tree right out of a gravel bed. Sometimes they can be a little bit unstable. Most of the time they're not. But in this case, where this tree was planted, they decided to put three stakes on it, three attachments. And again, instead of using stakes, they use more of a guying system. So a stake would be a stake driven into the ground coming up about this high, then with a point of attachment. A guy, the attachments go down to the ground and you have low stakes that are driven in. Six one, half dozen the other. They both work well. The guying system works really well for big trees with a lot of wind sail. So why on earth would they use a three-stake system like this? It's not that big of a tree in a situation like this. It's not that windy here. One of the things that we have found is that vandalism almost always of trees is unintentional. People walking by, if it's too close to the sidewalk or near a park, near a school or something, they're grabbing it. That's when you put on a three-stake system or a three-guying system in this case. But if you look closely at it, again, the system, the attachments are flexible. There's a lot of space in here for the tree to move. Three guy stakes, three points of attachment, all of them loose, allowing that tree to move and build up that stem caliper. So really good system, and it does discourage this unintentional vandalism. So that's all we have for a little bit of a primer on staking newly planted trees.